Far Cry New Dawn is the opportunity to bring Far Cry to the post-apocalyptic world.
A post-apocalypse setting is something that we were itching to do for a long time, but put our own Far Cry spin on it. I think that's what players are going to find in Far Cry New Dawn.
I think it's super interesting to see how a world could be transformed by such an event. And you know, at Ubi, we like to really study how we build our worlds. So we actually took the time to study how the world could evolve in 17 years after such an event.
So what that means is that after the apocalypse happened, we had some years of nuclear winter where everything is dead, everything is dry, nothing is growing anymore. After that, there was some periods of harsh winds where the winds were blowing around all the sands. And next up, we have a long periods of rain. And that's where Far Cry New Dawn takes place. It's called the superbloom. What it means is that all of a sudden you have these beautiful flowers and beautiful lush vegetations coming out of a very desolate, dry place. And that's where Far Cry New Dawn takes place.
It's really different. There is now sand dunes and there is the super bloom. It transformed that place and it creates new opportunities. These sand dunes, they're great to like jump with the buggies.
Nature has reasserted itself in a big way in Hope County. Wildlife has changed. The people who live there have changed. So we thought it was the perfect opportunity to explore that.
So we knew from the beginning that we wanted to avoid the cliche post-apocalyptic setting. We knew we wanted to make a world that's been colorful, inviting, and just really lush and different. And people who are coming back from Far Cry 5, we also wanted them to explore something completely new and a different setting.
And then, yeah, what 17 years did to these characters that you loved or that you hated?
Far Cry New Dawn is the narrative sequel to Far Cry 5 in the sense that we're coming back to Hope County 17 years later. But it is the next standalone Far Cry experience. So the player is a new player character coming to Hope County for the first time. If you have played Far Cry 5, you'll get an extra sense of satisfaction in reuniting with people that you've spent a lot of time with in 5 and seeing who survived, and of those who survived, how did it change them? How did this story affect them?
How we picked the characters from Far Cry 5 that are coming back is coming from two different angles. One is the writing team from both games, getting together and saying, he lives, she dies, he lives, she lives. I was super exciting to debate who we should bring, and we looked at who the players were appreciating, and we brought these characters. We're bringing back the Guns for Hire, and we have two brand new Fangs for Hire. So we are actually bringing a new dog. Sorry for the people who love the Boomer. Boomer is dead, it has to be said. I won't say what happened, but 17 years, whew. But we have a brand new pet dog. He's called Timber. He's an Akita dog. And we listened to the community and they were asking for being able to have the dog coming with you in the vehicles. And now he can do that, and it's pretty cool. This time we're bringing a massive giant boar. For me, it's a perfect addition to the roster of Far Cry. He's called Horatio, Horatio the boar.
We had the creative freedom to kind of go a bit crazy. And one of my favorite things are the wildlife in Far Cry New Dawn. So where in the past something might feel like it was rare, in Far Cry New Dawn it's the new norm. So for example, in our game, you might come across a lot of white albino deer. And besides those, you'll come across so many different animals that you might not have even thought existed before with their colors. And my favorite, the hummingbirds. We have hummingbirds all over Far Cry New Dawn. And I think that's something that everyone's gonna love.
We are bringing a place we call Prosperity. It's a home base. It's going to be a place that the player is going to rebuild. You will bring the victims and your friends there. And that's where also, in return, they will help you build better vehicles, better weapons. And you have this threat coming from the east called the Highwaymen.
The Highwaymen roam the countryside, going from place to place, taking whatever they can or whatever they need to survive.
Which is led by Mickey and Lou, the twins.
When we were coming up with the story of New Dawn, we were looking for opportunities to change things up. The idea of twins, it changes the dynamic of these scenes and the way that they interact with the player, but also the way they interact with each other.
It creates a lot of unexpected movement and action and dialogues. Actually, when we were building the game and doing the research, we were super excited to find a way to give the player the opportunity to visit other places and see what the collapse did. The expeditions enable you to visit other places that have been affected by the collapse.
You have a bunch of new locations that are going to bring a fresh take on that players didn't experience in Far Cry 5.
And we picked locations that would feel drastically different. The maps are gigantic. It's like a 1 square kilometer by 1 square kilometer, so it's very large. All are totally unique. because these maps are separated from the open world, we don't have the same constraints. So for instance, we can put way more enemies. So the experience is much more intense.
There they are! Not today, today.
The exciting thing for us is that given that the world is so much more chaotic now in this landscape, we could really take that intensity and really kick things up a notch in terms of how far people are willing to go to survive now.
The post-apocalyptic world gives us opportunities to go a little bit crazy, to have fun, and that's what we did.
Ooh, hell yeah! Now that's a fucking punch!
Follow me.
For the craving that teeth-breaking crush.
Gotta go right for the face every time. They never see it coming.
Had that roasted dog before coming here. Peeled protein course into my veins.
The scab's all weedy.
Nothing fills me up like roadkill.
Just kids when the bombs dropped and the world went to shit. They said it was supposed to be the end of everything.
But for us, it was just the beginning. Surviving, nah, we were better than that. This new world had a lot to give and we took it all. That's how we came out on top. That's how we got here. That's how we found you.
Listen here, rabbits. You need to understand something. The only currency left in this world is power. We're gonna take everything from you, starting with your home. And if we can't take it, we'll break it.
For the end. The flames devoured everything. And when death rolled through our valley, our world turned cold and dark. The years of rain, the howling winds, gave way to blue skies and a new world in bloom. We felt hope. We were wrong.